Mechanically, it's super easy to do a reverse definition. What's a reverse definition? It's just a wrong definition. It's just an incorrect definition. That's the logical way to look at a reverse definition. And because a reverse definition is wrong, your brain is going to try to avoid doing it because your brain is going to say, well, don't write something that's illogical. Yes, that's actually what you need to do here. You need to write something illogical and then using humor, philosophy, brilliance, changing reality, doing whatever you need to do, show how your wrong definition reveals some bigger underlying truth. Like great humorists like Mark Twain or Oscar Wilde or the Sophists of ancient Greece, you need to use some cleverness to demonstrate that the wrong definition in some way is more right than the right definition. The mechanics are easy though. The tradition, let's look at the word friend. Traditional definition, a friend is an ally and a confidant. The reverse definition, a friend is someone who tries to harm you. It's incorrect, but if you can find a way to argue that it's true, it's going to have to be clever. There's no simple-minded, boring, tedious, obvious, dumb way to do it. You have to be clever to argue the reverse definition. That's what's good about it. It forces you to think cleverly, to think outside the box, and that thinking is what's going to make your essay stand out and be unforgettable. But let's look at the at what sometimes your mind will do instead. Your mind will say, okay, well, we don't want to keep the original definition, but we don't want to do a wrong definition. Let's try something else. We'll just give an attribute. What's an attribute? Some small description of the thing you're talking about. It's not a new definition. It leaves the original definition in place. It just adds some little minor thing. Let's take a look. A friend can be kind. Okay, that's true, but that doesn't negate the original definition. That's just something we add on to the original definition. It's an attribute. A friend lives near you. Again, that's not negating the original definition. That doesn't go against the original definition. It doesn't in any way violate the original definition. It's just adding some minor little ornament to the original definition. So attributes are not reverse definitions. When you're doing these reverse definitions, remember the reverse definition or the alternative definition is going to be wrong, according to the dictionary, is going to be the wrong answer, and then you're going to use cleverness to show how your wrong answer reveals some deeper, more profound, more powerful underlying truth, and that's what's going to make your college essay unforgettable.